Hello guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. And today we are going to start with a new chapter, class 8th chapter 1 geography. So as you know, the name of chapter is resources. So what do you mean by resources? Resources are something which help us to satisfy our needs, which help us to fulfill our needs, without which we are not able to survive. In this chapter, we will also know different types of resources. So here we begin with the presentation. What is resources? I have told you earlier also. Anything that satisfies human need is called a resource. Gift of nature, such as oil, soil, water, forest, and minerals. As well as human creations like building, roads, these all are known as resources. Now we'll talk about that. What is the value of resources? The natural resources are highly beneficial and can be put to any use with human technological efforts. It means that the natural resources are very important for us, and it can be used by human, and also some advancement can also be done with the help of different kinds of technologies. And these are the great sources of economy, that is wealth of nation in our country. These all are the natural resources. As you can see, soil, water, stones, pebbles, and manure. Now it comes different and four types of value attached to resources. There are four values which are attached to resources. First is conservation of forest, animals, and water bodies. That how can we save, how can we conserve animals, animal life, water bodies without polluting them? How can we save water bodies without polluting them, not throwing waste in them? Second is science, beauty of schoolers, lakes, beauty of science. If you do not spoil the beauty of science, science means mountains, lakes, parks, which are being adjusted in our society for our needs. After that, resource being used for manufacturing or produced have economical value. The resources which are manufactured and produced, those resources have a particular economical value. After that, we come for various sects and regulation related to clean area. There have been many steps, or you can see many various types of regulations, various types of impacts are being taken for cleaning the air, water pollution, free environment, and legal levels. After that, we come on the next topic, that is classification of resources. How resources are classified on different varieties, on different platforms. There are three types, that is natural, human resources, and human made. Natural, which we get from nature. Human resources itself, humans, and human made resources, which are made by humans. Correct? Okay. After that, we come to natural resources, things which are taken from nature and are without such changes. The things which we take from nature for our health and without modifying them when we use it, that is known as natural resources. For example, water, minerals, rocks, these all are natural resources. This is the natural resource, as you can see in the picture. Then we classify the resources on the basis of organ. how origin biotic and abiotic organic biotic and abiotic two parts biotic means living and abiotic means non living so all the things which have life which survive in society which survive in nature which have sensation of respiration those all comes under biotic like human animals okay plants and the things which do not have life to survive which are non living in nature those things are known as abiotic organisms or abiotic resources such as earth is abiotic it does not respire it does not reproduce do respiration correct minerals do not respire wooden is react it can after that these are the living things and non living things means biotic and abiotic here in picture it is shown biotic resources for example plants protists means diseases like fungi allergy animals and different kinds of bacteria after that we come to non living organisms non living organisms such as water soil air light minerals then we come to the classification on the basis of distribution is eubiotic biotics localized eubiotic means these resources are found everywhere on the earth the resources which are found in everywhere on the earth each and every place like soil land air correct after that second part is localized these resources which are found only in certain parts which are not found everywhere in some part of the earth in some part of the nature it is found these resources are copper iron then it is water okay silver gold anything you can after that we come on the class on the classification of resources on the basis of distribution this is a scene I think we have done this yeah this is a scene sorry classification on the basis of renewability means renewable or non renewable the things which we can use again which respond through the resources quickly those resources are known as renewable resources and the resources which take thousands of years to get rebalanced to get responding those resources are known as non renewable resources theek hai ji let's see renewable and non renewable resources we have been some substances according to them so let's check first of all for renewable resources is solar energy water and wind how they renewable all of them because they respond to the calamities they respond to our technology which we are exporting on them fast and can be used again after using once renewable resources and these oil limestones these cannot be used again they do not respond to our technologies those resources are known as non renewable resources classification on the basis of level of development how potential and actual potential these are the certain resources not been used presently for much known about them moreover the technology required exploiters utilizing them may also not be available. These natural resources are called as potential resources, means which are not used in present resources, which are not used in present time, may be used in future, and even they do not have such technologies that we can use them for a particular time. So these resources are known as potential resources and actual resources. The resources which are used rarely, jo resources filhal used mein hain, which are used in present time and in further also they will be used. These types of resources are known as actual resources. For example, river like Sataluj, ठीक है, so this was all about in this video. In next video we'll talk about human resources, then we will talk about human made resources, then conservation, how can we conserve the resources, then we'll talk about sustainable development, and we'll talk about some part of question answers to recall what you have learned from the video. That's all. Thank you, and please keep on learning with me, and please like, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you guys.